My name is Florencia Molina. I am a labor exploitation survivor in the garment industry in Los Angeles. It was really hard for me to get money to feed my 3 kids. Even though I was working really hard, I didn't make enough money to support my kids. One day, when I was taking sewing classes, my sewing teacher came to my house and told me about this great opportunity to go to the United States. It was hard for me to decide to come to the United States, but at the same time was the only chance in my mind that I have to get some money. We flew from Mexico City to Tijuana, as she told me. Everything looked fine until that moment. I met my trafficker. The first moment I met her, I realized that she wasn't nice at all. She didn't tell me how much money I was going to make, how many hours or anything like that, but she told me that I owed her a lot of money. In order to pay her, I had to work for her, and she brought me to the United States for work, so I must work for her. My hours were 17 to 18 hours a day. 7 days a week, I had 10 minutes to eat whatever I could eat in 10 minutes during the 18 hours. I had to sleep in a storage room. I had to share the mattress with the sewing teacher. I wasn't allowed to put one step outside of the shop. She always threatened me, and she said if I didn't do whatever she asked me to do, she knew where my children were, and I didn't want them to pay the consequences. She said, if I kill you, nobody's going to care. Even dogs have more rights than you have. One day, I asked her to go to a church, and every time I saw her, I asked her to go to a church. And she said, oh my goodness, you are so insistent, you don't give up. She said, oh, you are so insistent, you are allowed to go. And when I got to the corner of that place, I realized that for the first time, I walked by myself, and nobody was watching me. And I decided not to go back. I'm speaking out because I want to help others. I think I'm in a privileged situation and I can raise my voice to get awareness and to get people to know what happened to me. I want to tell those people not to stay quiet, to raise their voice, to say something, because along the way, there's a lot of help.